Let's see our little framework in action here. So what I've got is my two little classes here of loggable and connection. And again, what loggable is going to do for me is enable logging. My connection is going to allow me then to handle my connection. Setting up the couple of properties for title and server, and then setting up the couple little functions that are going to simulate whatever it is that we're trying to do here. So in my case, it's going to be writing out to the log file and connecting out to the database. Then what you're going to notice is that I've got my little SQL database that I'm creating here. My little SQL database is then going to inherit from both connection and loggable, and we're going to set up the title and the server. And then what you're going to notice right here is here's our little fancy framework. And our fancy framework is going to check to see, hey, did we inherit from connection? If we did, we'll run the connect code. Hey, did we inherit from loggable? If we did, then we'll go ahead and run the log code. I'm actually going to move this down real quick here, just because I'm going to want to play around with a couple of things here. So I'm just going to move that down. No real big thing going on there, so just move that down. So there's my little framework. Now I'm going to go ahead and use the framework. So I'm going to inherit from connection and loggable to enable that behavior. And so now, when I create the instance and I go ahead and pass it through my high-end framework, what I'm going to notice is that it's going to tell me that it's logging the SQL connection demo and that it's connecting to some server. And, whoops. There we go. Sure enough, that's exactly what we get. So it's connecting out to the database, log the message, because again, that is what we went ahead and inherited from. Now, what's great about this little framework that I've created here is the fact that if I want to do something else, so let's say that I'm going to create a brand new class, and this is going to be just a logger, then what I can do is just inherit from loggable. I can go ahead and set up my init just like that. I really don't care about the super. And then I'm going to say self.title. You'll notice that I get IntelliSense here because I'm inheriting from loggable. Set that to be just logging. Go ahead and save that. Let's go ahead and create a brand new instance. So we'll say just log equal to just log, boom, boom. And then we'll go ahead and just log like that, pass that in, again, to our very fancy framework. And now what we're going to notice is the fact that it's only going to do our logging. So now with this framework, what I've enabled for developers that are going to be using this is that ability. So if you want to be able to connect, you can do that. If you want to be able to log, you can do that. So kind of really a nice way to set up and work with that framework. So like I mentioned at the outset, we want to typically avoid setting up multiple inheritance when we're writing our own code, unless we happen to be setting up a framework. But instead, we will be using it quite frequently. So when we're using other frameworks. So if you're heading out and maybe learning Django or learning another framework that depends upon mixins, this is the magic that's happening. That you inherit from yet another class, you go ahead and set up a couple of properties, maybe set up a couple of methods, and then voila, something really cool is now happening inside of your application. This is what's making it happen. It's doing exactly what I did here. It's checking to see, did you inherit from a class? If you did, then we'll go ahead and call a couple of things on that. So that is multiple inheritance and mixins in Python.